Okay, so I am going to be criticizing the extremes of both sides of the political spectrum, both the alt-right and the regressive left. So, a few days ago, I posted my Superwoman response video, and in that video I explained of how I primarily like black women. And it was probably unnecessary for me to have mentioned that right then, but for this video, I think that is important to mention it for some context. So, I primarily like black women, I am into cross-racial relationships, but that does not mean that I will not acknowledge beauty in all races of all women, it just means that I primarily like black women. I cannot explain it, just like a gay man cannot explain why he primarily likes dudes, just like a lesbian cannot explain why she primarily likes women. And so, when I saw the title of this video, Muhammad Ali attacks anti-white BBC Parkinson's disease, yeesh, that's what that reminds me of. I was thinking to myself, Muhammad Ali, there must have been more to him. Now, I do not know much about Muhammad Ali, but when I saw the title of this video, I was thinking to myself, apparently Muhammad Ali was an anti-social justice warrior. He was a man before his time, before this whole social justice crap came up, as he was attacking the, well, social justice culture. But it turns out that that is not what he is primarily attacking. Muhammad Ali is apparently against cross-racial relationships, and considering what I just told you guys earlier, that I'm into, well, black gals, that kind of hits me on a personal level. I'm not a social justice warrior myself, I am not a leftist in any way, I am a self-acclaimed conservative, but the fact that Muhammad Ali goes, on this spiel of his, it kind of offends me. So, let's get to it.
Black people must do something for themselves and not always beg white people to move in the neighborhoods, but clean their own neighborhoods.
So far so good, right? He's attacking Black Lives Matter before Black Lives Matter was even formed. But then...
And I'm sure no intelligent white person watching this show, or no intelligent white man in his or her right white mind, want black boys and black girls marrying their white sons and daughters, and in return introducing their grandchildren as half-brown, kinky-haired black people.
Okay, Mr. Ali, is it really the job of the parents to determine for their kids who they are and are not to marry?
I wouldn't object to that.
Well, you wouldn't, but a lot of them would.
Well, I'm sure a lot of people would. No, it's the point.
What I'm trying to say is this. And you don't have it. You say you don't, but you don't have it. You really ain't going to have it. You're on the show, and you got to say that.
No, that's not true.
Why would you want to do that?
Because I don't think I'm any different from you, you see.
Yeah, we much different.
That's, I mean, I think society has made us different.
You know we're different. We're all together.
But society has made us different.
No, not society. God made us different.
No.
If you really want to go off on a limb and talk about of how God supposedly made white people different from black people, well then I guess we'll be getting into racial stereotypes at that point. We can talk all day long about how stereotypically white men make better swimmers and black guys make faster runners. But it is not impossible for a black guy to be a good swimmer and a white guy to be a fast runner. I mean, it's just racial stereotypes is all it is. And in the end, Mr. Ali, we are all human. That is the point that Mr. Parkinson's is trying to get into.
No, we're just human beings. He made all of us.
We all, listen, bluebirds fly with bluebirds. Red birds want to be with red birds. Listen, tell me when I'm wrong. Pigeons want to be with pigeons.
But
tell me
when
I'm wrong.
They
don't have intelligence, but yet they stay together. We should have more intelligence than them, right?
The point that Mr. Parkinson is trying to make is that because we are uniquely intelligent amongst the animals, that because also we have a whole bunch of other unique features different from the animals. Like, for example, we like to have cross-racial relationships, some of us.
Buzzards are with buzzards. Buzzards are with buzzards. Bluebirds are with bluebirds. They all are birds. But they've got different cultures. The eagles like to hang out in the mountains. The buzzard like to fly around the desert.
Well,
the bluebird like to fly around the trees and the grass.
Okay, I honestly do not like it of when people try to compare us humans to other animals. But let's play along with this for right now, shall we? So Mr. Ali specifically mentions birds to try and make his point. But what about dogs? Dogs crossbreed all the time. Birds may not crossbreed, but dogs crossbreed all the time. You have Labradors making out with pit bulls and so on and so forth. So what about dogs? If we're going to compare birds, to say that that is a justification for why humans should not crossbreed, should not have cross-racial relationships, then isn't dogs a case for why we should be allowed to have cross-racial relationships?
Problems a buzzard mating with a sparrow, wouldn't there?
What?
There'd be certain...
right. And that's, we have the problems too.
I don't see...
So my only guess is that Mr. Parkinson is trying, emphasis on trying, but failing to articulate that biologically there are concerns with birds crossbreeding with each other, but biologically there should be no concern with a black guy making out with a white woman. But Muhammad Ali, he just ignores that. Instead, he tries to focus on the social problems of humans having cross-racial relationships.
I don't see no black and white couples in England or America walking around proud holding their children.
That's only because back in your time, Ali, back in the time of this interview, 1971, only 29% of Americans approved of interracial relationships. But now, today, or at least in 2013, according to this Gallup poll graph right here, 87% of Americans approve of interracial relationships. So I don't think those social disapprovals will be so much of a concern anymore nowadays, Mr. Ali.
That's because society...
And going out.
That's society's fault. We've got to educate people around it.
Well, life is too short for me to be raised catching hell for something like that. I'd rather go and be my own. I have a beautiful daughter, beautiful wife. They look like me. We're all happy, and I don't have no trouble. I ain't that much in love with no woman to go through all that hell. Ain't no one woman that good. You understand?
I understand, yeah. I do understand. I understand. I think it's sad that
it ain't sad because I want my child to look like me. Every intelligent person wants his child to look like him.
Well, no shit, Muhammad. But I don't think that anything should get in the way of you loving your own damn child, especially something as vain as the kid looking like you or having the same pigmentation as you. And by the way, it's not like it's impossible for interracial kids to look similar to their parents, to both parents. I mean, take this family picture, for example, of an interracial family. The kids look fairly similar to their own parents.
I'm sad because I want to blot out my race and lose my beautiful identity. Chinese love Chinese. They love the little slanted-eyed, pretty brown-skinned babies. Pakistanis love their culture. Jewish people love their culture. A lot of Catholics don't want to marry number of Catholics. They want the religion to stay the same. Who want to spot up yourself and kill your race?
What the heck is this bullcrap right here? When somebody is infatuated by somebody of a different race, of a different color, are they really... Is the thought process going on in their mind that, oh, I just want to marry that person of a different color because I hate my own race and want to eliminate my own race? Who the heck goes around with that thought process? No, people marry people of different colors because they like what they see and they like the personality and like the person for who they are.
You a hater of your people if you don't want to stay who you are. You shame what God made you. God didn't make no mistake when he made us all like we were.
Oh, please, Ali. It is not an ungratefulness for how one person looks at oneself for them to want to marry somebody of a different race or color. What is an ungratefulness for how you look at yourself is if you was to, like, get breast implants, for example, or steroids, or if you was to forcibly change your skin color to something unnatural, to the color that you weren't born with. Like Rachel Dolezal, for example, who was originally a white girl, then she tanned herself to try and make herself look like a black woman.
I think that's a philosophy of despair.
Despair?
I really do.
It ain't no despair. Yeah? Listen, no woman on this whole earth, not even a black woman in Muslim countries, can please me and cook for me and socialize and talk to me like my American black woman. No woman, at last, is a white woman.
Well, I'm glad that you are grateful for who you married, Ali. Rest in peace, Muhammad.
Can really identify with me and my feelings and the way I act and the way I talk. And you can't take no Chinese man and give him no Puerto Rican woman and holler about we're in love and you emotionally in love and physically, but really they're not happy because she's going to hear some Puerto Rican music, he's going to hear some Chinese music, and they're going to be clashing all the time.
So it's impossible for a person of a particular race to like music that defies their racial stereotypical music? Well, I guess Muhammad Ali is right. Wait a minute.
It's just nature. You can do what you want, but it's nature to want to be what you own.
I don't think anyone can deny that line of logic right there, Mr. Ali. But me personally, when I want to be with somebody of my own, I'm not thinking I want to be with other white people necessarily. I am thinking to myself, I want to be with other people of similar ideologies, political and religious. But even then, if I just hang out with people all the time that are of the same beliefs or same color, well, that is pretty boring in my opinion. So I might want to mix it up a little bit. In fact, everyone might want to mix it up a little bit. So, yes, it is natural for people to want to be with their own, but on the other hand, people might think that'll get kind of boring.
I want to be with my own. I love my people. That's all. I don't hate nobody.
And that is the end of the video. And might I have to say, I had never seen such a stupid logical... Wait, what? What the heck? What the heck?
In time, Europe must be multicultural.
Overly Africa dramatic
for the
much?
African, Asia for the Asian. But black countries for everybody. This is a matter of straight genocide.
Oh, I kind of forgot that there was a little bit more to this video. Yep, overly dramatic.
Anti-racist is just a code word for anti-white.
Anti-racist is a code word for anti-white.
Anti-racist is a code word for anti-white.
The multicultural system, the system devoted to your genocide, and it is devoted to your genocide, it's devoted to white genocide, is being destroyed with the sound, with the vibration,
right,
with the whole contradiction.
White genocide, white genocide!
Anti-racist is a code word for anti-white.
That's the terminology and the consistent message through Europe.
You know, I never really get the logic of far right-wingers and alt-right people regarding white genocide. They scream this word, white genocide, for if there is some diversity exhibited. Like, for example, when it came to Star Wars 7 and the fact that they had one of the main characters being a black dude, they cried out, WHITE GENOCIDE! WHITE GENOCIDE! That is not a sign of white genocide. By definition, genocide is the systematic and intentional destruction of a certain group. There is no systematic, much less intentional, well actually there's no intentional, much less systematic destruction of white people. Like, if for example people were actually rounding up white people into slave camps, killing them off, that would be genocide. But that is not what is being done right now, because the country is becoming more diverse. That is not white genocide right there. Now, I have been criticizing a lot of the far right regarding this issue, but I haven't touched on the regressive left. I do not agree with the regressive leftists either in that diversity is absolutely, utterly needed. Like, for example, there was this video that I watched a few months back that was complaining about how 60% of the USA was white. I'm thinking to myself, and? Like, I do not agree with the far left regarding that we must need diversity, that we must force diversity onto people, including the racists. I mean, let the racists be as they will. That is their prerogative, as long as they are not violating the right to life or liberty of any kind to people that they might hate because they're of a different pigmentation. Like, a lack of diversity is not in of itself a problem, and no amount of legislation and no amount of diversity or lack of is going to turn people who are racist into non-racists. And what you have to do is you have to teach them and raise them right. Because if you were to create legislation that says you should not be a racist, they're only going to pretend to not be a racist. But when, say for example, there's absolute anarchy in the country, they will ultimately show their true selves. And I don't agree with alt-righters that we must remain nationalistic on our colors. Keep all the nations of one same color, like for example Africa, keep it black, Asia, keep it Asian, and Europe, keep it white. And I know that in that interview that Muhammad Ali did not specifically say that we must force people to not have interracial relationships, that we must not have diversity, but his reasoning for why people cannot have interracial marriages is just wrong, to be quite frank. But I don't agree with either of you guys on this issue. I do not agree with forced diversity, but I don't agree with racial nationalism either. Hello fellow YouTubers, if you liked the video, hit that like button down below. If you want to see more videos like this, hit subscribe. If you want to see me respond to a specific article or video, comment down below with a link to the said article or video and I might consider responding to it. Anyway, thanks for watching and God bless.